HPP272 can also communicate with the system by using Modbus RTU digital communication. If this Modbus is something completely new to you, let me give you some advices how to get started. For that, you will need this USB cable that you use for communicating with the probe and the inside PC software. But this cable can be also used for demonstrating and testing RS-485 communication protocol, where the Modbus RTU is built on. So let's take a PC and connect the probe. Inside PC software detects the probe automatically, but this time we will not use Inside PC software. For that, we actually need to find what is the virtual COM port number that this USB cable is providing to this computer. In order to find that, we have to open a device manager in Windows. And you should look for these ports, COM and LPT. And here you should find Vaisala USB device. And in my configuration, I have this in COM 11. You probably have some different COM port there. But keep this in mind. And then we also need a user guide and some program that can actually talk Modbus with the probe. And I recommend to take a look what kind of program you want to use from modbus.org. And here you can find technical resources. It's up to you what type of program you want to use, but I will use this modbol, which is a very nice command line tool for testing the Modbus communication. I have already installed this software in my computer, so I can test that everything works. Modbol-H will give me a help. So now I need to open a manual. First I need to set the communication so that the communication settings are the same. So this command starts with modpol, and then I will use RTU protocol here. And the default address of this probe is 240. And then I need to also adjust this parity. As we can see, the default parity is even, but this Modbus protocol is actually using none. So let's change that. And then we need to also adjust the stop bits to 2. Okay, now it's time to check what kind of registers we want to read. And here is really the advantage of Modbus protocol. With the analog outputs, we were able to read only 2 values. But as you can see from the address mapping, there are lots of different parameters that we can actually read from the probe. So let's read 6 different values, starting from the register 1. Sorry, a typo here. And we will read 6 values. And these are floating point numbers. So let's use T and 4 float, meaning that we are now reading holding registers. And then one important thing is to set the right COM port here. And here we have values. And if we diagnose what kind of values we get there, we can see that there are not a number for the register, for the first register and second and third register actually gives us a value, and this is the temperature. And the reason why we cannot get any values is that this probe is currently in a purge mode. And how do we know that? So, of course, we can ask it from the probe by using a Modbus protocol. It's starting from register number 513. And we are going to read actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values. Why 5? Because we want to read integer values here. And the first register is 16 bits, but the second is 32 bits, and also the third. So with this command, we are able to read these three registers. And now we can see that 513 is showing that there is some kind of notification. And this 516 register tells us something. And we can check the error codes here. It says that the purge is in progress. So let's wait until this purge is completed, and then we can read the other values also. Okay, purge is completed. Now it's time to read these measurement values. And there we can see them. So let's find the spot in the manual so that we know what is what. Vaporized hydrogen peroxide is showing now 8 ppm. And relative saturation is 16, temperature is 24, and relative humidity is quite the same as relative saturation. And then there's also absolute hydrogen peroxide value and mixture dew point temperature. And these are very useful parameters for some applications. So this Modbus protocol is quite handy, because you can get all these parameters with the digital protocol. Okay, this was how to use digital Modbus communication. And next step for you is to implement this communication in your PLC or other control system that you may have. I highly recommend that you consider this option instead of analog outputs, because it can offer much more than the analog technology can offer, such as you can get all the measured parameters and also all the status signals from the measurement probe, and you can also control the purge with this digital protocol.